Hello everybody, my name is Denis and you are watching CloseToAlgoTrading.
In the last video, we discussed the common structure of the algo trading system. And today, I will try to create a simple, high-level design of a homegrown trading environment. Let's start from the beginning and think what we expect from our environment. I want to add new strategies and data sources in future. Let's say I want my system to be scalable. Now I am working on the stock market, but maybe in 1 year I will be trading cryptocurrencies too. It means I want to have a possibility to add a support of a new markets. And of course, I want to change my code easily. After we have set our goals, let's see how the trading environment looks like. We have the data and the trading system. Also, I want to have a user interface to be able to control my environment. And as an additional block, let's say I want to have a simulation system. The data drives the whole system. Let's go inside of this block. Let's say, in the beginning we plan to use only the information from our broker and the files on the hard drive. But then, we decide to have access to different databases and news agencies. As long as we want to have access to many different data sources, we need to support different drivers. Drivers are used to provide us with the simple functionality, like read or write data, open or close connection, and so on. I showed it here just because we need to understand that the driver is an extra component in the software. And I don't want to work directly with the driver's API from my trading system. For this reason, I need a special layer which will implement data handlers. Data handlers are components that work with the drivers directly. They implement the logic functionality, like serialization and deserialization of the data or converting it to a special format. We have a set of data handlers. But we still don't have a unified interface for our application layer. This interface will be provided by Data Manager and Order Manager. Data Manager provides a common interface for working with the data sources, and Order Manager provides a common interface for the order execution. So, the system will use both interfaces to have access to all kinds of data sources and broker services. Here is an important moment. We defined components which provide the common interface to access our data sources. It means that if our trading system wants to get news, for example from our broker or from database, it will use the same interface. And this interface will not change if we change the data provider. With such system design, I can always add new data sources or change the broker, and it will not break the application functionality. Well, now after we have created the design for working with the data, let's go to the main user of it, the trading system. If you have already watched my previous video, you may know how the trading system looks. There are 5 blocks. The first 3, alpha model, risk model, and transaction cost model, generate input information for a portfolio construction model, which decides how to allocate the resources and create a request to the execution model. So, these blocks of the trading system can use the data manager and order manager to access the data and the broker services. We have described the data and the trading system components. But now, we need to define who will control all of it. Definitely, we need a component that will be responsible for the whole system. We need to create, let's say, a basis application. This application will implement the whole startup sequence. Driver and component initialization, and also the main state machine will be implemented here. After we have defined a main application, we need to think about our user interface. Maybe it will be only a normal PC interface, or maybe we will implement a web interface. In any case, it is a good approach to split the front end from the back end. For this, we need to create a communication layer
between the graphic user interface and our core application. What else? I forgot one important block. It's a logger component. This component will implement the logger interface and store the log to a database or a log file. After we define the logger block, maybe we can use a web-based monitoring system to track our environment. This system may have a direct access to the database server and read data directly from there. Also, the front-end application could have access to the data using the data manager and to the broker services using order manager interfaces. Who knows? Maybe we want to have a possibility to execute our orders manually. Well, I didn't describe the simulation environment because I think it is out of the scope of this video. But, saying in short, the simulation environment could be implemented just like an additional broker service. And we don't need to change anything in our system. Looking at the design of our trading environment, we can say that we can achieve our goals. We broke our application into separate domains and connected all of them through the interface layer. Data and order managers should provide common interfaces to simplify the access to the resources. Now we can easily change the data vendors or brokers. Also, we can use different user interfaces. And of course, we can make changes in part of the system without updating the whole application. Well, that's all for today. Maybe I forgot something, or you think that this design is wrong. Let's discuss it. Leave your comments and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. See you guys in the next video. Bye!